They're doing it now for the first time in 10 years. The last time they did it was with Muhammad Hassan and The Undertaker, when The Undertaker was attacked by terrorists and CNN was all over that, and they had to kill off the Muhammad Hassan character just so fast that they brought him in professional wrestling. Now they're doing it again, seemingly, with a different twist, only this time, instead of having Islam going up against the United States, it's Russia and the United States with Mark Henry and Alexander and Lana. But the thing is, WWE have done a great job putting over Roman Reigns. I mean, yes, he mightn't have been the last thing that you saw on Raw this past Monday with everything going on with the United States and Russia, but he was in a main event match, in my opinion, against Seth Rollins, a match that was good enough, in my opinion, to be headlining house shows, and I believe it was a few months ago. Now they have a rematch coming up at Night of Champions, and it's going to be interesting coming off of Reigns' victory over Rollins to find out where they go from here. Obviously, Seth Rollins will probably upset Roman Reigns in an impressive match that we'll probably see at Night of Champions, and I do predict it to be a very impressive match with everything that's went on between the two former Shield members and everything that's gone on from their singles careers since the severance was originally caused in the Shield by Seth Rollins. Obviously, the direction that it will go is that Seth Rollins will eventually cash in his briefcase to become WWE Champion and be one of those successful Mr. Money in the Banks, which there have been many from previous years. Everybody from Edge to Mr. Kennedy to everybody has cashed in a briefcase and been very successful. Edge, Rob Van Dam, Jack Swagger, they have all done it to win either the WWE or World Heavyweight Championship. And actually, Mr. Kennedy didn't cash in. It was Edge who capitalized on an injury of Mr. Kennedy to win the briefcase and go on to cash it in on The Undertaker after a cage match between Mark Henry and The Undertaker on SmackDown, the same SmackDown that Ozzy Osbourne performed a song, I Don't Stop, on SmackDown a few years ago, back in 2007. That was over 7 years ago. The point being, all the Money in the Bank briefcase holders, with the exception of a few, John Cena and Damian Sandow being the only two who haven't successfully done it. With the exception of two, at least 95% of the 100% of people who have cashed in that briefcase have made good on their promise to be a future champion. And Triple H and Stephanie believe that Seth Rollins is going to be the next future superstar in WWE. And the most obvious outcome of Night of Champions could be that Brock Lesnar loses the title to John Cena, and then Seth Rollins comes out of nowhere as Plan D, cashes in the briefcase and defeats John Cena. And then for the next few months, we have Seth Rollins being chased by John Cena in an effort for John Cena to become, say, a 17-time champion, or they wipe the victory of Brock Lesnar off his record from Night of Champions and say he isn't a 16-time champion because of the way that it happened and occurred. And then we have Seth Rollins and John Cena feuding over the 16th reign of John Cena, with John Cena chasing after Seth Rollins, who would be your champion. But, you know, where does that leave Roman Reigns, even if Seth Rollins defeats Reigns at Night of Champions and goes on to cash in the briefcase on whoever wins the match for the title at the Night of Champions pay-per-view, because he's the one that wants to leave an impression in the minds of wrestling fans and images that will be instilled in their minds for many years to come. Where does that leave Roman Reigns? I don't know, but to be honest with you, I am really pissed off with what they're doing with Roman Reigns, because I was a Roman Reigns fan for 3 or 4 months ago, but not so much as I was 3 or 4 months ago now, because of what they're doing with his character. It seems as if they lost a sense of direction with Roman Reigns, and that's got to be really disappointing, not just for me, but for all wrestling fans out there who were fans of Roman Reigns and who would put Roman Reigns in their top five list, because there were many wrestling fans who had put Reigns in their top five list. I know Booker T, if he were still doing the Fave Five list, which he did when he was doing commentary for SmackDown, probably would have put Roman Reigns in the top of his top five list, probably within the top three, because of the impression that he's been leaving in the minds of wrestling fans and the images he's been leaving with still in the minds of wrestling fans, images that will not be wiped clean from the minds of wrestling fans who support Roman Reigns and who most of all believe in Roman Reigns. The question I have for our fans on Facebook, and the purpose of dropping this video blog actually on our YouTube channel, is to find out if you are a person who believes in Roman Reigns, and if you are, I invite you to join the conversation on our Facebook page at HEW Entertainment, with over 1,000 fans listening to our show. On Twitter, you can tweet us your opinion on Roman Reigns. There's a follow-up to Roman Reigns being a future WWE Champion video blog, which I dropped just a few weeks ago on our YouTube channel at Jonathan Clark 1 with 32,000 tweets, and you can leave me your comments at the bottom of this video in the follow-up to Roman Reigns being the future WWE World Heavyweight Champion on our YouTube channel at Jonathan Clark 22. Let me know what you think of Roman Reigns, and let me know if you believe in Roman Reigns. To be honest with you, I don't know if I believe him or not anymore. I believed him 3 or 4 months ago when it looked like he was going to be champion. Now, I don't know if I believe in Roman Reigns as much as what somebody out there who's a diehard fan who will try to convince us that he's a diehard fan, or she is a diehard fan, don't mean to be biased there, he or she is a diehard fan of Roman Reigns, and the question is, I guess, at the end of the video blog, is are you somebody who believes in Roman Reigns? And if you do, join in on the conversation and let us know how you feel about the recent direction his career has taken. Do you think it's for the better, or do you think it's for the worse? It can't get any worse for Reigns than what it is now, and I guess that's the most likely outcome of this, is that he'll eventually go on to win a major championship, if not that, a minor championship, which would be the Intercontinental or United States title. How do you feel about it? And do you see Roman Reigns getting out of this predicament? Do you believe in Roman Reigns? Join the conversation and tell us what you think. Here is Becky G and Shower. I will see you next week.
Like what you hear? Tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Like what you hear? Tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
Something about ya got me feeling like I can't be without ya. Anytime someone mention your name, I be feeling as if I'm around ya. Ain't no words to describe you, baby. All I know is that you take me high. Can you tell that you drive me crazy? Cause I can't get you out my mind. Think of you when I'm going to bed. When I wake up, think of you again. You are my homie, lover, and friend. Exactly why you light me up inside like the 4th of July. Whenever you're
Something takes place in the world of professional wrestling. You know where to go. WrestleZone.com. WrestleZone.com. Covering all the latest breaking news daily. Interactive forums where you can chat with thousands of other wrestling fans. Exclusive editorials and audio features by some of today's top wrestling superstars. Exclusive video content. Weekly polls. Live play-by-play coverage of every WWE and TNA pay-per-view. And now, featuring WrestleZone Radio, live, with news, in-depth discussions, debates, and interviews with wrestling's top stars, past and present. When you think wrestling, think WrestleZone. WrestleZone.com.
He considers himself God's gift to wrestling, and millions of his faithful agree. With nearly 4 hours of footage and exclusive commentary and matches, this DVD chronicles Daniel's rise from Chicago's Windy City Wrestling to the Asylum in Nashville, and finally to the top of TNA. TNA Home Video presents Heaven Sent, Hell Bound, The Best of Christopher Daniels. Available at most retailers and TNAWrestling.com.
Hey you, right there, the one listening to this show. While you're tuning into this broadcast or when you read the news on WrestleZone.com, are you forming opinions of it all? Or do you just agree with everything you see and hear? If you actually have some sort of afterthought, which, by the way, is normal, we want to know what it is. There are thousands of wrestling fans just like you that simply can't hold their thoughts in either, and they let it all out in our interactive forums. You have a voice, so use it. Simply visit forums.wrestlezone.com. Don't just be active, be reactive in the official WrestleZone.com forums.
For all the latest in mixed martial arts, be sure to visit WrestleZone's sister site, SureDog.com. Complete with daily news, exclusive video, interviews, live radio broadcast, interactive forums, and the very popular Fight Finder, with bios and complete match-by-match histories of your favorite fighters. SureDog is the only place you need when it comes to mixed martial arts. Visit SureDog.com today.